Hi friends, Niket here. On 15th June 2020, 2 days before, ICAI had came up with announcement related to your May 2020 exam. They gave you two options. One, you can continue to give your examinations which are scheduled from last week of July, or you can opt out and give your examination in November 2020. If you choose to opt out, it will not be counted as your attempt. Now, this was the announcement. There were a lot of queries related to the announcement in the minds of students. So today, ICAI has came up with FAQs, frequently asked questions related to that announcement. Okay, I'm just reading few of the FAQs which I feel are important. Full FAQs you can read from ICAI website, as well as the link is given in description of this video. Let us see some of the FAQs. This is from ICAI. It's given on 17th June 2020 today. Frequently asked questions. This is related to the announcement they did on 15th, related to that opt-out facility which they had given. Now, what are that FAQs? Let's see. First one is simple. What precautions student has to keep? We all know it. Face mask, hand sanitizer, social distancing, that is fine. I'm not reading that. Second is also fine. Going to third one. What will happen if any student has a fever? Imagine while your exams are going on, you have a fever. They will do a thermal testing. They will pakka do a thermal testing, they've written. Now, if I have a fever, would I be allowed to enter the examination hall? Answer is no. If you have a fever, you will not be allowed to enter exam hall unless you produce a certificate from doctor telling this fever is not due to COVID. So would you be allowed? Answer is no, you are not allowed. However, if a student produces a medical certificate that the fever is not due to COVID, if you produce a certificate that fever is not due to COVID, minimum MBBS or a higher degree wale ka certificate, then you will be allowed to enter. Otherwise, if you have a fever, they will not allow you. Thermal scanning is must. Next, I go to fifth one. Will the examination centers be sanitized on examination dates? So will they be sanitizing the exam centers every exam? Answer is yes. ICAI definitely cares for your safety. Don't worry about it. They are more concerned. Every exam, the exam center will be sanitized. Next, going to seventh. Okay, seventh and eighth are for those students who are in old syllabus. Now, for old syllabus intermediate, IPCC exam. For old syllabus intermediate, that is your IPCC exam, the last attempt was May 2020. And then they had to compulsorily shift to new syllabus. The old syllabus intermediate student last attempt was May 2020. If you choose to opt out in November, old syllabus only will be there. The old syllabus intermediate student last attempt was May 2020 for them. If you choose to opt out, yes, for you, November may you can give intermediate under old syllabus. Now, question was, sir, if I don't choose to opt out, I give exams in July, and by chance I fail, can I again give in November under old syllabus? By chance, if I fail, I hope that doesn't happen. But suppose it happens, and can you again give in November? Answer is yes. The intermediate old syllabus, the attempt has been extended till November for all students. If you choose to opt out or you don't choose to opt out, you can give again in November old syllabus intermediate. So check. This extension of intermediate up to November only for those students who opt out, or it's for all? It is for all. So if you give exams in July, old syllabus intermediate, by chance you fail, can you again give in November under old syllabus? Yes. Now, eighth one is for final students old syllabus. If you are in CA final old syllabus, the last attempt under old syllabus was November 2020. After November 2020, they have to mandatorily shift to new syllabus. Now, sir, if I choose to opt out, I am missing one attempt. So they have extended old syllabus final exams, they've extended till May 21. So if you choose to opt out, you can appear in November 2020 and May 21 also, old syllabus final will be there for those students who opt out. For those who don't opt out, they are appearing in July, they can appear in May for them, sorry, November, for them May 21, old syllabus will be there or not, it's not yet decided. But looking at the language, it feels they will extend it. So final old syllabus, for those who choose to opt out, they can give in November 20, May 21 also will be available under old syllabus. For those who don't opt out, it's not clear. See, will November 20 be the last attempt for final old syllabus? So they've written, for students who opt out, they are given extension up to May 21. For students who opt out, they are given extension till May 21, November 20, May 21, you will have two attempts under old syllabus, final. For students who don't opt out, who are not opting out, examination committee will recommend to council for necessary support to student. For those who are not opting out, you can appear in July, you can appear in November. May 21, old syllabus final will be there or not, not clear. But they are telling, we'll recommend to council for necessary support to student. So mostly, May 21 will also come for those students who are not choosing to opt out. 7th and 8th, only for old syllabus. Next, important. Sir, this May exam is delayed. November exam will be held timely or November exam will also be delayed. They've clearly given November exam will be held in 1st December, first week of December. So whether next exam will be held in November or December, they've given it will commence from first week of December. The November 2020 exam, yes, it will start from first week of December. Now, sir, things were fine. Now my house has become in an area of containment zone. So now my house comes under containment zone, what to do? If your house later comes under containment zone, you are shifted to next attempt. So what will happen if your residence comes under containment zone while exams are going on? While exams are going on, you come in a containment zone, you're not allowed to move out. You are automatically shifted. Such student will be given option to apply for opt-out facility. You have to show the authority's order. Authority's order that this area is now under containment zone. And you'll be shifted. No extra fees, your exemptions, etc. are carried forward. So while exams are going on, now my area comes under containment zone. You will be shifted to the next attempt. You will be shifted to next attempt. Sir, what if exam center comes under containment zone? Exam center comes under containment zone. They've said they will try to find a new exam center nearby. And if they are not able to find, all students will be shifted to November attempt. Yes, your fees will be carried forward, exemption will be carried forward. So if exam center comes under containment zone, they will try to see a nearby exam center. If exam center is not available, you'll be shifted to November 2020 exam. All students of that centers are shifted. I hope you're clear. Next, sir, if I'm from such a city where the situation is bad, like Bombay, Delhi, in that case, what will happen? If they are not able to conduct the exam for entire city, is it possible? Yes. Then all students of that city are shifted to November attempt. It is possible they might not have exams in any particular city, that's possible. So what will happen if a particular city may not be able to conduct the examination due to the high risk? So what to do in that case? So they're telling all students of that city are shifted to November 2020 exam with the fees being shifted and your exemptions transferred. Now, 13, 14, they are very good. Imagine you gave first two papers. Third paper, your residence comes under containment zone और एग्जाम सेंटर इज कमिंग अंडर कंटेनमेंट जोन. तो योर रेसिडेंस कम्स अंडर कंटेनमेंट जोन, एग्जाम सेंटर कम्स अंडर कंटेनमेंट जोन, दे टोल्ड ओके यू आर शिफ्टेड टू नेक्स्ट अटेम्प्ट. सर आई हैव गिवन टू पेपर, डू आई नीड टू गिव ओनली थर्ड एंड फोर्थ? नो, होल ग्रुप इज ट्रांसफर्ड. इट्स नॉट पेपर वाइज ट्रांसफर, इट्स ग्रुप वाइज. टू पेपर्स वर गिवन, टू वर पेंडिंग, यू टू गिव ऑल फोर नेक्स्ट टाइम. बट हाँ सर, ग्रुप वन वॉज ओवर, ग्रुप वन वॉज ओवर, ग्रुप टू का वन पेपर वॉज डन, सेकेंड पेपर वॉज देयर, देन फर्स्ट ग्रुप नो नीड टू गिव अगेन. इफ ग्रुप वन वॉज कंप्लीटेड, लेटर योर रेसिडेंस कम्स इन कंटेनमेंट जोन और द एग्जाम सेंटर कम्स इन कंटेनमेंट जोन, यू आर शिफ्टेड टू नवंबर अटेम्प्ट. हाँ, इफ द ग्रुप इज ओवर, दैट ग्रुप नीड नॉट बी गिवन अगेन. बट सर, थ्री पेपर्स वर गिवन, लास्ट वॉज पेंडिंग, गिव फोर पेपर्स अगेन, ऑल फोर पेपर्स अगेन. इट्स नॉट पेपर वाइज, ग्रुप वाइज. इफ यू आर गिवन थ्री पेपर्स, ऑन फोर्थ डे योर एग्जाम, मतलब योर रेसिडेंस कम्स अंडर कंटेनमेंट जोन, सच स्टूडेंट विल बी शिफ्टेड टू नवंबर, दैट्स फाइन. बट काइंडली नोट, see the words, kindly note, the student has to write the whole group, that is all four papers again. Sir, three were already over, one baki tha, you can't do anything, you have to write the whole group again. Sir, first group was over, then no need to write the first group, then only second group you have to write in next November attempt. Okay, this is done, 14 is fine. 15, what will happen if student is found COVID positive during exams? Okay, during exams or before exams you are COVID positive, you are allowed to choose to opt out and you will not be allowed to enter exam. If you are found COVID positive, you can shift to November. So such student will not be allowed to appear for this exam. He can choose to appear for next exam. No need to pay fees again. And your exemptions, etc. will be carried forward. Now, sir, if I don't choose to opt out now, can I do it later? You can do it only if your residence comes in containment zone. If I don't choose to opt out now, can I do it later? Only in case the residence comes under containment zone, then only you are allowed. Sir, if I opt out now, can I later change my mind and give exams in July? If I choose to opt out now, you have to choose till 20th. So till 20th June, you choose to opt out. Can you change your mind and give exams? No, that's not allowed. If you choose to opt out, later can you give? Not permitted. That's not permitted. And so, can I change my city afterwards? See, they are opening the window. Correction window is open till 20th June. You can change your exam center. Sir, can I change after 20th June? No. The correction window currently is allowed till 20th June. Later, can I change it? They say no. So can a student change a city after, see the word, after the correction window is closed? That's not permitted. If you want to change your city, you have to do it till 20th June. Sir, I choose to opt out. Others, the exam was there. I choose to opt out. For others, exam was there. But ICI again delays it. Due to situation, it's not in their hand. They again delay it. Everybody will appear in November then. Don't worry. If again there's a delay, everybody will appear in November. Now, sir, if I choose to opt out, which are the documents I need to submit? If I choose to opt out, which are the documents I need to submit? You have to give a declaration. They've given a format. So fill that declaration, take a printout, scan it, upload it. Fill that declaration, take a printout, scan it, upload it. Sir, what if I don't have a printer nearby? Everything is closed nearby, printer is not there. Handwritten declaration. Handwritten declaration, mobile may you click a photo, scan it, upload it. That's fine. Okay, this were the important FAQs. All FAQs are available on ICI website as well as the link is given in the description. But I tell you one thing. I still say that if you are from a less risky area, you and your parents are comfortable, please go and give examination. You are from a risky area, you or your parents are not comfortable, then you can definitely choose to opt out, give it in next November. See, people are trying to get back to the normal life. You know, many cities or many towns, villages are such wherein you don't have much cases and the things are kind of getting back to normal. So there's no problems over there. You can definitely go and give exams. ICAI is going to take all precautions required. So don't worry about it. If you are from less risky area, you and your parents are comfortable, definitely appear for July. But from risky area, not comfortable, don't hesitate. You can choose to opt out. It's just a matter of 2 months. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.